That's some news that's just coming in right now, where expelled AIADMK MP Sasikala Pushpa has now moved to Supreme Court seeking a CBI probe or a judicial investigation by the apex court into the death of the former Chief Minister J Jayalalithaa. In her petition, Pushpa has alleged that Jayalalithaa's death was suspicious as her actual medical condition was never disclosed. No one was allowed to visit her. Her funeral photographs showed embalming marks and everything from her hospitalization to her death was kept under wraps. This Rajya Sabha MP of the AIADMK has sought directions to the center, the Tamil Nadu government and Apollo Hospital, where Jayalalithaa was hospitalized, to disclose details of her health report and treatment in sealed cover to the apex court. A similar plea was filed this week in the apex court by Tamil Nadu Telugu Yuva Sakthi, claiming that doubts have been raised over the circumstances of the AIADMK leader's death and a medical report needed to be examined by experts.
Madam Sasikala Natarajan is commanding the entire administrative system. I think so, and people also think that the system, I don't think that I can get justice there. So I directly filed a writ at the Honorable Supreme Court of India stating that we need justice, and I made a respondent that Apollo Hospital and Chief Secretary of Tamil Nadu, they have been added as respondents. Because Madam Jayalalithaa, Madam Amma is not a personal individual person, she is a public person. I just want to get justice from the judicial system. So that I filed a writ petition yesterday.
Let's go across to my colleague Lokpriya, joining us over the phone line with further details. Morning, Lokpriya. We're looking at Sasikala Pushpa, who continues to create further trouble for the AIADMK. Now she's, of course, moved to Supreme Court over details being sought of Jayalalithaa's health and her death.
Well, that's correct. The expelled AIADMK MP Sasikala Pushpa has moved to Supreme Court seeking a more detailed investigation on the death of Chief Minister J. Jayalalithaa. Remember, even earlier she had stated that there was a mystery that shrouds the demise of J. Jayalalithaa and the details of the medical treatment that was given to her at Apollo in the course of 75 days need to be made public. So now she has gone ahead and she has filed a case at the Supreme Court where she has made the state government as well as the Apollo Hospital as respondent. But for their side, the state government has maintained that there is no mystery that has shrouded the death of J. Jayalalithaa, and the Apollo Hospital were regular in their medical bulletin. And even the opposition parties have demanded for a white paper on Jayalalithaa's death. They say that not enough information is in the public domain, and there is a confusion and a mystery that shrouds J. Jayalalithaa's demise, and hence the state government and the Apollo Hospital should come forward and give in detail what transpired in those 75 days.
Right. Lokpriya, what's been the response really of the authorities concerned over here? You were telling us how the government of the state has been saying that there is nothing hidden from public, because yes, indeed, Apollo hospitals were coming out with medical bulletins, but the fact is that those medical bulletins only started coming out with a lot of pressure, and they were far and few in terms of the number of days in which they would come out.
Definitely, yes. Apollo Hospital was very economical when it came to their medical bulletins of former Chief Minister J. Jayalalithaa. In the beginning, when she was admitted, it very clearly said that she was admitted for dehydration and she was receiving treatment. It was only during the later course that they had started coming out with specifics on the exact ailments of the former Chief Minister. In about a span of 75 days, there would have hardly been a dozen of medical bulletins. So considering that, the state government says that an expert team of doctors spread across the globe, right from Singapore, London, as well as our own AIMS Institute, these doctors have sought, have given the treatment, and so they have given the best treatment that's possible. So the state government does not have any locus standi on giving reply to the concerned people. If at all anyone, they only need to ask the doctors, and the state government does not have any locus standi. That has been the AIADMK stand.
Mm-hmm. And Lokpriya, talking about Sasikala Pushpa over here, you know, be it the role that Sasikala Natarajan has to play or the death of J. Jayalalithaa, we're looking at time and again that she continues to needle the AIADMK.
Well, that's correct. correct. She was expelled from the AIADMK for not maintaining the discipline of the party. And this had happened about 2 to 3 months back. And now the people at the AIADMK do not take her as a party member, and they say that she's only doing this because she was expelled from the AIADMK and she only wants to bring bad name to the party, and that is the reason why she's indulging in such games. So that is what the AIADMK has to say on the threat that Sasikala Pushpa has been making.
Right, we'll leave it at that for a moment, Lokpriya. Thanks very much for joining us with those details.